everyone. Welcome back to a new chapter about NGINX Unit language modules. In this module, we will do the first step into the magic world of application server handling or application server-like handling of NGINX Unit. So I think the part that might be the most interesting one for you, as this is really the bridge between your application code and NGINX Unit. So let's jump on my computer screen and let's get started. So I'm back on nginx.org, on unit.nginx.org. It briefly changed this to HTTPS so that we can make use of all the copy commands and things like that. So where to find actually information about the Linux language modules? Let's start here with supported app languages. Supported app languages list all the languages we support. And I would like to start with the first three followed by the other ones because of a good reason. The language modules or the concept of language modules with NGINX Unit is divided in two different main parts. We have application modules that implement an given interface based on the programming language. For example, Java, the WebSocket API, specification 3.1, or the Servlet API 3.1, sorry. Perl using PSGI, PHP using the PHP Server API, Python, WSGI or ASGI, Ruby using REC version 2.7 or 3.0, 3.1 REC API. So these are implementing a given standard from the programming languages. The first three, binary compiled language using the embedded libunit library, go by overriding or node by overriding or loading the HTTP interface, works different. Those three are basically go in JavaScript. We have an application type that, or a language module type that is called external. And this external will use different approaches to send the request to a Go or Node.js binary. For example, for Node.js, we will overload or override the HTTP or WebSocket modules loaded by Node with the ones we have created for Unit. Same applies to Go, but we will learn how that works in more specific, in a more specific way while we do the deep dive for Go and Node.js. So these are the languages we support. So now let's see how to install a language module. To do so, we go to installation, official packages. And as we are on Ubuntu, we click here, 2204. And then we see down here in the app install section, let me make this a little bit bigger, the different packages we have. And you see this little question mark can tell us for some of the packages necessary or additional information. For example, if I hover over unit dev, it tells me it's required to install Node.js module and build Go apps. This is something we will discuss in the lecture about Unit for Go and Node, but keep that in mind that unit dev package is a thing and it's probably needed. So beside of that, we have Unit Go, Unit Java 11, 16, 17, 18, Perl, PHP, Python 2.7 and 3.10, and Unit Ruby. Necessary for Unit to pick up any changes in language module setup is to restart Unit. That is important to know. Unit will pick up the language modules configured or installed on startup. So that means we can install basically all this by just copying it, going here. Let me go in my home directory and paste that in. All right, that is weird format. Control A jumps at the beginning of the line. Sudo apt install unit dev unit go Java 11, Java 16, Java 17. Let me clean this up a little bit. I want to install 7 or 18 only. I want to install Go and I want to install Perl and unit PHP module and Python 2.7, probably not. Let's stick with 3.10 and unit Ruby. My password for invoking root commands. All right, now it tells me, okay, it will load the language modules, and as they come with a set of dependencies for PHP, for example, the binaries for Go and for Node and like all that dependencies for the unit dev package, it's asked me, hey, do you really want to do this? And as we are on our box, I'm typing yes. That will just install basically the language modules for me. Will take some time to run. And in the meantime, I would just like to explain a couple of things here. Probably, so for example, if you want to use unit for PHP or unit for Python, you don't have to install all of the language modules on your box. If you want to play around, like I'm always absolutely into playing around with different languages and see how stuff works. And that's why I'm just installing everything we have here, from dev to Go to Java and Perl and PHP and Python, Ruby, everything. That's totally fine. If you want to do it more precisely and you want to use it for Python or PHP only, you only have to install the language module for that specific language. So while this is still running, we go back to the website and I will show you one thing. Well, actually, let's do this on the code. So hitting the command key on my keyboard again, typing terminal once more to open another one. Terminal, all right, new tab here, click, perfect. So I make this a little bit bigger for us. So now we have already learned unit D dash dash version. And here, we can see dash dash modules. And in dash dash modules, we see user, lib, unit modules. All right. And we have learned already from the website that we have to restart unit to grab the modules or to load the modules into unit. So first of all, let's go and check what is inside user, lib, unit modules. User, lib, unit. All right, it's still installing, it's still downloading. So this directory will be created based on the package with the first language module that will be installed, that will create the modules package, and we'll then put the shared object files, the .so files, into this directory. So we give this a couple of more minutes to finish, we are nearly there. And then we check out the units module folder again. And another good thing is, let's grab, or let's check here with the cat or less command, the unit log file. That is not what I wanted, leunit.log. Oh, I did not specify any command. That is dump. Probably with double S, that should work a lot better. Right. So in here, we see this notice saying no modules matching user lib units modules *.unit.so found. So, and after restarting unit, we will notice that this message will change. closing this, clear the screen, go back in here. So now it's installing. As said, if you install that for a single language, it will take a minute or two to install. But as I install it right now for all the application languages we support, it'll take some time to run. But I wanted to give you the real world experience, not cutting the video too much, not stopping the recording or anything, to give you a feeling or an impression how long it'll take to download and install all the language modules we support on a plain Ubuntu box. As said, this box was completely empty. As you see, there was nothing installed previously, so we do everything from scratch. So it's unpacking the modules. It's giving us the examples that come with user shared dog unit Ruby examples as well. It's creating a PHP INI files for available modules. That's what we see here right now. So we are in the PHP stage. Still, that is PHP. Still PHP. That is Java. Right, look, a lot of key files for Java. That is creating triggers, and we are done. All right, after the installation finished, took some minutes, we are checking right now where the modules were installed. Just as a little reminder, we can do -unitd --version to see where our modules directory is. It is in user lib unit modules. So we use user lib unit modules to see Java is here, Perl is here, PHP, Python, and Ruby. And they have told us, hey, restart unit to load the actual language modules. To do so, we can sudo restart unit to restart the process. And then we can check the unit log, sudo less var log unit.log. And we do this, and this will tell us, hey, we discovered the modules for Java 18, Perl 5.3, 4.8.1.2 for PHP, Python, and Ruby. And that means we are ready to go and learn more about each specific language and how to use it with NGINX Unit. So in the next lecture, we are going to check out Unit for Python with the Python module for Python 3.10. Really looking forward to it. Let's have some fun in the next lecture and see you all in chapter number 10.